Interviewing for a job that's data focused or requires Excel skills, expect to be asked more than just, do you know how to use Excel? I've interviewed many, many people for positions where Excel skills were a central part of what they'd be doing. It's usually pretty clear from people's responses to these questions who's actually used the tool and who uses it more just for data entry. Today, we're looking at the five most common types of Excel interview questions and exactly how to answer them. Welcome, I'm Jen. We're going to look at five common Excel interview questions that could be asked in any job interview. If the job description specifies other specific skills in Excel, be prepared to talk about those as well. This is going to be a little bit unique to every job. The first Excel interview question is, what functions do you find most useful? From the interviewer's perspective, this answers two different things. This question automatically assumes that you're familiar with the functions and how to use them, and also which ones will come in most handy for the type of job you'll be doing. Think about your answer a little bit in context of the role you're applying for. For most positions, though, there are going to be a few functions that are great ones to talk about. Don't bring up a function if you're really not sure how to use it or you haven't made much use of it, because if you're asked further questions about it, this may look like you have less skill than what you have instead of more, since you won't be able to explain it. So, which functions are good to talk about, assuming that you know them? The if statement is a good one to talk about. This can be used in a huge variety of scenarios. And when you nest it with other statements or even multiple if statements, it can become extremely complex and handle a lot of logic. VLOOKUP is another one that hiring managers like to hear about. This is a common function you should know if you're utilizing functions in Excel. While it has its limitations, it also does offer a lot of functionality. Alternatively, you could talk about Index Match. This both shows an advanced knowledge of Excel functions and also shows that you recognize some of the limitations of functions like VLOOKUP. The second Excel interview question is, have you used pivot tables and how have you used them? As a hiring manager, again, I'm not going to let you just say, yes, I've used them without explaining a little bit more. The best way to talk about pivot tables is to talk about something useful that you've done with them. This could be something in your current job. Without sharing private company information, you can still talk about how you use that pivot table. Maybe you used it to analyze sales per month by region and by salesperson. This speaks both to your analytical ability and your ability to use Excel. The third question I like to ask is, what types of Excel charts do you like to use? This is again a bit of a loaded question because I'm really looking for a few different things in your answer. I do want to know how familiar you are with Excel charts, but I also want to know your mathematical capabilities and some of your data visualization inclinations. There are two answers here that I really don't like to hear. The first, pie charts. Pie charts have an excellent place. They're very valuable if you're looking at a snapshot in time and comparing just a few things on a percentage basis. The problem with pie charts, though, is they're often used way more often than they should be, and they don't give the impression to the person looking at it that you really want them to take away. It's also not a great way to compare data over time by showing multiple pie charts side by side. Again, occasional use is good. They do have their value, but this shouldn't be your go-to main chart. What would I use instead of a pie chart? I talk about bar or column charts. They tend to make a more clear impression on the people that are reading them, and they also allow you the ability to show changes over time, especially when you get into stacked bar and stacked column charts, or you add in a line chart over top. The other type of answer that I'm always a little nervous about is when people talk about liking to use 3D charts as their default, or things that have multiple axes so that you have height going up, you have things going front and back and side to side. These can look pretty cool when you put them together, but a lot of times they're really difficult to read. So maybe they're good in a report where no action is being taken off of, but if you want the reader to have a takeaway that causes them to take action in a certain direction, these types of charts often aren't the best way to convey the information. Bar or column charts or stacked or combinations of different chart types are great things to talk about in your answer here. Talk about the practical application where you've used them and when you might choose one over the other, depending on how the conversation after this question goes. The fourth question that you might encounter, and I personally like to ask in an interview, is tell me about some of the Excel work that you're most proud of. This gets people talking more about their hands-on application with the tool. Lots of people can show they have certification or training in Excel, and that's good to an extent. You need a foundation to build working off of. But if you don't know how to take that and turn it into action and apply it to the data you have and the issues you're trying to address or the tasks you're trying to accomplish, all of the training in the world is meaningless. So be able to talk about some practical things that you've done with Excel. What types of data did you use? How did you make it useful? Was it something that you could easily update when new data became available? These are great things to talk about in answering this question. The last Excel interview question that I like to ask, and this is specific to people that are doing data analytics work, is when would you choose Excel to do your analysis over SAS or Python or R or whatever the data analytics tool is that that company uses? There are times when Excel is the better choice. While Excel can't do everything that these big analytics tools can do, sometimes, especially if you're doing an ad hoc, one-off, small analysis with a small amount of data, Excel is going to be quicker to use and easier to get to the end result. This is especially true if you're mainly summarizing data or making some simple graphics. It's also a great place to do the work when you need to share the actual source data and the working information with someone else that's maybe not as familiar with the data analytics tools or doesn't have access to them. Those are my top five Excel interview questions and how to answer them. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up so I know you want to see more videos just like this. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.